Welcome back and thanks for your company this Tuesday morning. Well, this week, veterans will be commemorated for their service in the Vietnam War, 50 years on from the era-defining conflict.
Yeah, former Governor-General of Australia Sir Peter Cosgrove was one of the 60,000 young Australians who served all those years ago. And he joins us now from the Australian Vietnam Forces National Memorial in Canberra. Good morning to you, Sir Peter. Thank you so much for being with us. Now, half a century on, you were there. You were there in Vietnam. You commanded a rifle platoon on a personal level. Tell us about the significance of this 50 years on.
Well, we were all young then, and we're now the veterans, the old veterans amongst that veterans community in Australia. But 60,000, as you said, went there. There's 35,000 left today. And we're going to have a commemoration here on Friday, here in this beautiful bush capital in the sort of precinct of memorials. And the place has been transformed. There's tiered seating. We're having a bumper crowd. There'll be thousands of people. And about 10:30 on Friday morning, we'll all stop and remember and think about all those ones who've passed on, and indeed about the war at large, what it meant to Australia and all the controversy and all the suffering and the gallantry of people who served so well.
Yeah, interesting words you use there, you know, the controversy and remembering all of it, because it was at a time, I guess, where we were all really tuning into the impact of war and what it was happening, not just in Australia, but globally. I mean, it's so difficult for us to imagine the conditions that you would have faced. It was a brutal war for anyone involved. When you think back at it, what was your experience like?
Well, my experience was wholly favourable. I got the privilege of commanding some wonderful Australian men, both regular soldiers and Nashos, extraordinary brave fellows who they're lifelong friends now. I was honoured to be amongst them. But I do understand that there's so many people have been traumatised by the war and by their memories of it. And indeed, back here, there was disquiet amongst a section of the population about the fact that here we were at war. You might say it became the forerunner of the war seen and conducted on television.
Yeah, 523 Aussies died there in Vietnam, 2,500 wounded, many, many more dying since then. Peter, how will the government be commemorating on this important day?
Well, there is the ceremony at large, and that will be led by the Governor-General. There'll be a lot of veterans here, obviously members of the government, but there'll be thousands of ordinary men and women, families, particularly the families, I hope, of those who are no longer with us, those who died in Vietnam or who have passed on since. I hope they come. There's also things like a memorial medallion that's been issued and available for veterans or their descendants to claim and keep as a memento. There's various other things that are in the wings. There'll be gatherings around Australia in other capital cities. No doubt Vietnam veterans will gather there to remember their mates.
So, Peter Cosgrove, we thank you for your service.
Thank you for joining us this morning.
I'm here today, of course, to say farewell to one of those great warriors, Philip Bennett, who commanded a battalion at the Battle of Coral on the 12th of May 1968. Magnificent battalion, great commander. He's a sad loss.
Yeah.
Yeah, his life will be honoured by all the veterans there, as
thinking
well
of him
as
and,
the nation.
And all those soldiers and all those families, all those famous battles, the Battle of Long Tan, the Battle of Coral, which you mentioned just there.
Yeah.
So, Peter, thank you so much.